Aya! Welcome! It's number two from my new series, Minidisc Monday. If you missed the last one a couple of weeks back, it's basically me going through my entire Minidisc collection. Old releases, newer indie releases we'll get to at some point as well. And I just want to showcase a collection that I've had so much fun and enjoyment building up over the past almost 10 years, I think it was, when I got back into Minidisc. This edition is going to be a little bit different from what I planned to be the norm, as I'm going to show you two Minidiscs, but it's mainly about the one, but there's another one that's related to it. So the Minidisc that I really wanted to talk about today was Head Music by Suede. This was their, now then, it'll be their fourth studio album. It got to number one in 1999. Probably, I would say, not the peak of Suede, as I think Suede had peaked probably during Coming Up in 1996. And by all accounts, this was a difficult album to record. There was infighting in the band. Brett Anderson had quite a severe drug addiction at the time. They ended up producing what would be their final really good album until they reformed over a decade later, as the follow-up to this one wasn't that good really. It had a couple of alright tracks on it, but I did rank the Suede studio albums not too long ago. I ended up listening to this again for the first time in many years, just to decide exactly where it would place in my rankings, and it was pretty high. I think it was number 3 or 4, to be honest. It's a really good album. I do enjoy this album a lot. We'll go through the track listing in a moment. I'll just show you the back there, which is quite plain. The sleeve, by the way, is designed by Peter Saville Associates. Of course, Peter Saville, very famous for designing sleeves for Joy Division, New Order, OMD. There's a look at the disc itself. Label on the front. Printed track info on the back there. Just checking I was holding that the right way around. Very similar to your audio cassettes of the time. It comes with pretty much... that is all the insert you're going to get. There's no extra pages or information. I mean, it's got a lot of the production info on the back page there. This one's remained in pretty good condition. Couple of scratches on the front. It is possible to buy replacement cases that are pretty much identical to these sorts. These, what I would call original pre-recorded Minidisc cases. Techmoan did a video about them a couple of years or so back. So if I decide, because I know I've got some albums in my MD collection and the case is just absolutely wrecked really, so I ought to maybe try and replace some of those. But as I'm going through my entire collection during this series, then that'll be something I can sort out as and when really. Yeah, this is mainly about Head Music, which I think is a little bit of an underrated Suede album. It's not their best by any stretch, but it's certainly not their worst. But I did want to show you another Suede mini disc, because this is a bit of an anomaly, not just in the Suede discography, but in music in general. Because, and if you don't believe me, believe the little hype sticker, this was the very first, or the UK's first ever mini disc single. And to the best of my knowledge, it was the last one as well. Now, there might be some hardcore Minidisc historians and collectors, and if there is any, please let me know. We'll come in the comments and say, no, actually, there was other Minidisc singles. But this is the only one I've ever come across. Minidisc, and I thought this for many years, was really just an album format. You know, there was no intention by anyone to release Minidisc singles. Of course, CD singles would have been the major singles format at the time. You've still got stuff on 7 and 12 inch vinyl, and also cassette singles, although I think they were on the way out really by the late 90s. They were still pretty much widely available. So while this is classed as a single, it has got 5 tracks on it. Electricity, which was the lead single off Head Music, Pop Star, Killer, See That Girl, Waterloo, and Implement Yeah. So it's an unusual thing, this. This wasn't a lot of money from what I remember. It's from someone on Discogs, and it wasn't much more than between £10 and £15, this. Whereas if you're looking for Suede albums on Minidisc, Head Music, I think, was relatively reasonable, but the others are just so much money. There you go, similar inserts to the Head Music album. But I just wanted to show you this as well, as to the best of my knowledge, it's the only technically single, not just by Suede, but by any act, that came out officially on Minidisc. So an interesting sort of anomaly for the collection. When I saw that I could get this cheap, probably around the same time I bought Head Music, to be honest, I thought I would get this. But back to Head Music, because I just want to go through the tracks on here. We've got Electricity, Savoir Faire, Can't Get Enough, which I think was a single as well. Everything Will Flow, that was definitely a single, and one of my favourite tracks on the album. Down, She's in Fashion, that was a single too. Asbestos, the title track, Head Music, Elephant Man, Hi-Fi, Indian Strings, He's Gone, and Crack in the Union Jack. Good album, as I said. All I've really got to say about it, I've not got any other Suede on Minidisc. All the other Suede albums I've got, I do own them all now, are on vinyl. A lot of them reissued vinyl in more recent years as well. So I am a Suede collector. I would say this, if you can find it and it's under £20 on Minidisc, yeah, pick it up. But otherwise, just buy the reissued vinyl, really, as that'll be a lot easier to get from many places. Well, maybe not many, but more than what the Minidisc is available at now, certainly. I want to show you these two, and this one accompanies this, as it's the single from the album, Suede's Electricity and Head Music. So thank you for watching this edition of Minidisc Monday. Come back again in 2 weeks' time, and I'll have chosen another interesting album to give you a closer look at on what I would say is music's most underrated and fun format of all time. I want to say special thanks to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. I'm going to go now, and please will you join me again in 14 days' time for number 3, part 3 of this series, Minidisc Monday. Cheers, everyone. See ya!